It's CPI week. Inflation figures from around the globe will drive the markets in the coming 5 days. The US, EU, and UK are all reporting their latest CPI numbers. Buckle up. It could be an active week in finance. All right, it's quiz time. Answer this question correctly, and you may receive a free month's access to the How to Trade Trading Room. Here it is. What does the abbreviation CPI stand for? Is it A, the Consumption Price Index, B, the Cambridge Poverty Index, or C, the Consumer Price Index? Post your answers below, and best of luck. This week's CPI action begins on Tuesday with the release of U.S. CPI. The markets expect CPI to fall to 0.1% month over month and rise modestly to 3.8% yearly. On the core CPI front, inflation is expected to come in flat at 0.3% monthly and fall to 3.8% yearly. Now, all year long, U.S. CPI has been one of the premier market drivers in the world. This release should be no different, as it will surely influence December's FOMC meeting. On Tuesday, our key market will be the NASDAQ 100. Tuesday's U.S. CPI number is going to be a huge number, specifically for the NASDAQ, which has been our most active stock index. As you can see right here, we're definitely in a bullish trend really since last fall's lows. You can see this three-month pullback. We stalled out at 38%. That tells me that I have a bullish read all the way up to all-time highs. If we get a very, very hot CPI number, then we may get an opportunity to buy in down here at 38%. If we get a low CPI number, then we'll have an opportunity maybe to buy just a short-term retracement on our way to all-time highs. It looks to me like this CPI number really will tell the tale for the U.S. 100. Right now, bullish, unless we get a hot number, and then we'll look to buy a pullback. So either way, bullish.
Hot on the heels of Tuesday's U.S. CPI report, the U.K. is due out with their CPI during the Wednesday London session. It's no secret that inflation has run rampant in the U.K., reaching multi-decade highs. Wednesday's Office for National Statistics report will give us the latest on consumer prices in the United Kingdom. Now remember, high CPI figures are hawkish for that nation's domestic currency. This can place bearish pressure on risk assets such as equities. Now we'll focus on the Great Britain Pound USD during this UK CPI release.
For about the past 2 months, the Great Britain Pound USD has been in consolidation. We had some good, nice moves during the late summer, early fall, and now we're just in complete rotation. For me, I'm watching the line in the sand right there at 120.86. That's an opportunity potentially to bid the market. However, if we do take that area out, then we will be looking for a big bearish move. Now, does that happen this week? Jury's still out on that. I think that you're going to see more consolidation, and when you get into those areas, you're looking to sell resistance and buy support. So to the top side, 123.13, to the bottom side, 120.86, you're looking to sell from up here and buy from our line in the sand until we see a break. And if we do break beneath that level, then we'll be looking to sell pullbacks. So consolidation, looking for a breakout on CPI, playing consolidation until proven otherwise. And if in fact we do get a break, then we'll join the bearish break. Last but not least is this Friday's CPI release from the European Union. EU CPI is expected to retrace from recent levels, falling to 0.1% monthly and 2.9% yearly. Now, one of the biggest concerns facing Christine Lagarde and the ECB is the onset of recession. The odds of a recession will grow if CPI comes in hot and another ECB rate hike becomes a reality. Now, the Japanese yen is one of our favorite currencies to fade this year. Why not head over to switchmarkets.com, open up a demo account, and trade the euro yen during this EU CPI release.
Since the beginning of 2022, traders have made millions trading against the yen or fading the Japanese yen. So when I see a number like EU CPI coming out, I'm thinking, why not trade the euro against the yen? So right here, we've got the euro yen. You can see really a stiff monthly long-term uptrend, and we are still trending higher. So the key numbers to look at here is your July of 2008 high, a historical level up there at 169.97 to 170. Look how much room we have. Right now, we're trading somewhere around 160, 150, 162. You'll see there's plenty of room still to the top side before we get to a level where maybe the BOJ will intervene. So how do we trade this really going into CPI? Well, the first thing is we adjust our time frame down to a weekly. You'll notice we're looking at really breaking out again on the weekly above that upper Bollinger Band. Once we get established with the week's high, remember this number comes out on Friday, then we'll look to buy a retracement on the weekly time frame. With a bit of luck, we'll get it around a big round number, 162, 162.50, maybe 163. So we're bidding the euro yen if in fact CPI gives us the volatility and the situation to do so. Pretty darn good trade. The trend is your friend. That's a fantastic way to follow it.
At the end of the day, inflation is everything. When consumer prices rise, the world takes notice. Central banks are forced to raise interest rates to shrink the money supply. These actions can dramatically impact employment, purchasing power, and economic growth. Not to mention they can also spark heavy volatility across nearly every asset class. Now make no mistake, this week is a big one. It'll pay to trade these three CPI reports. Make sure that you stay in the loop by subscribing to our YouTube channel. Also, check out a live stream or two in our How to Trade trading room. If you have any questions at all, ask them below. We'll be sure to answer as best we can. Until next time, trade well, make a few pips, and we'll see you in the markets.